Next up is geologist Michelle Barbosa Ramirez, who's going to be making beautiful crystals out of bismuth. So, enough of this chitter chatter. Let's get down to bismuth. It's Barbosa Rocks.
Hey everyone, it's me, geologist and paleontologist Michelle Barbosa Ramirez, with another episode of Barbosa Rocks. Barbosa Rocks! Although, actually, this is a mineral. And minerals, well, they're special because they have a set chemical composition and a crystalline structure. So what is a crystalline structure? Well, let's talk about a mineral that we all know, salt. Yeah, salt is a mineral, and because it's a mineral, it has a crystalline structure. It means that the atoms inside of it are actually held together in a three-dimensional structure. The molecular structure of salt is ordered and organized. You can see that the atoms are held together in a consistent pattern. It repeats. The crystalline structure is actually what lets these minerals form in those cool, like, geometric shapes that you see out in nature. Like with that salt we were talking about, or quartz, or even ice, because yeah, ice is also a mineral. Normally, it takes minerals a really long time to form those beautiful crystals, like millions of years long time. But today, we're gonna grow our own crystals here in the kitchen using bismuth. Now, bismuth is a metal, but it's also a mineral. And like all minerals, it has that crystalline structure. It can melt at 271.4 degrees Celsius. So we should be able to get this bismuth melted down pretty easily. Okay, so since we're gonna be working with molten metal in like really hot temperatures, safety first. So I'll put on my glasses and I'll get on my gloves. So I've already started melting down the bismuth, but let's add a little bit more. We'll give that just a second to melt down. Now what I'm gonna do is remove the slag from the top of the pot. And the slag is just metal that's already started to cool, but we wanna get it out of the way so there's a nice, clean, fresh surface for those crystals to grow out of. Now I'm gonna remove this from the heat. This nice, clean top layer that we formed, crystals are growing out from it. And then on the bottom layer, right, the bottom of the pan is also covered in metal, and crystals are growing up. So the trick is to stop the crystals from fully forming. So to make these crystals a little easier to get out, we're just gonna make sure that this top layer doesn't completely solidify against our pot here. So I'm pouring out all of this extra molten metal. I'm seeing crystals underneath. I just have to get through the top. Whoa, do you see how the crystal has grown in this crazy geometric shape? Now I have to try and get these out of the pan. Let's take a gentle approach. Come on, crystals, gonna break you. Ah! My favorite are these little towers. You can see sort of that step formation. This one looks like a city. I mean, so cool. If you take a look at a piece of table salt, and when you see the way that the atoms are fitting together, they're making a perfect little box shape, just like its atomic structure. In the case of bismuth, the reason that this is growing with almost like a cubic rectangular shape, right, with flat sides, is because that's the way that the atoms in the bismuth are arranging themselves at an atomic level. So crystalline structure, this is it right here. So that's it for this episode of Barbosa Rocks, crystals.
Hey, it's Miranda Cosgrove, your favorite host of Mission Unstoppable. I'm the only host. And if you wanna watch awesome STEM videos and exclusive Mission Unstoppable clips, just make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell.